hidden treasures of the 119th Psalm. Oh, so today we get to dig into what I would have told you was my favorite verse long before I started the study of the 119th Psalm. I've used it in boot camps time and again, and I've quoted it and thought about it in so many different ways. But when you think about it, today, of course, we're on the eighth verse of the Dalet section, which means it's kind of the fruit of all the other verses, all the other prayers are leading up to this biggie, which really is huge in the case of the Dalet, this oft-quoted verse. But I don't know if you remember a song from the Shondells back in the 60s, but it went sort of like, to do run, 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 to do run, run. Well, I can't help but think of that in my head when I think of this verse. So this verse reads in the King James Version, it's actually verse 32 of the 119th Psalm, which is the eighth verse in the Dalet section. It says, I will run in the way of thy commandments when thou shalt enlarge my heart. Well, I could say so much so fast, I don't know what to go to first. It's just such an exciting verse for me. Because can you imagine what it would be like to be able to just run as a servant of God, to run towards the things that he wants, and to run with your whole heart, which is what King David is going after, obviously, throughout the whole thing. So when we look at this, we have to, or we don't have to, but I like to think of what Jesus taught. What were the two greatest commandments, right? That was to love the Lord thy God and to love your neighbor as yourself. So, this commandment or this idea of commandments has everything to do with love. And of course, we've talked about it before. This word is mitzvah. But when you boil down the mitzvah, what are we talking about? Love God, love your neighbor. Right? So can you imagine, if you can just imagine that when you remember back to the first time you fell in love, got a crush, whatever you want to call it, when all of a sudden God enlarged your heart and you saw somebody or something that just made your heart come alive, like, oh my goodness. I can remember mine's name was Susan Siemens, right? And I used to just hang out around her neighborhood just so I might get a glimpse of her. I was so, my heart had been so enlarged. And believe me, when it said I would run to find ways to be around her because I was so in love. I just totally smitten with the whole, Susan Siemens deal. So what King David's asking here is really, really amazing when you think about it, because it has everything to do with the do, run, 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 right? That God is going to touch our hearts in such a way that we are falling more in love with him and more in love with our neighbor. And how does that happen? It happens through the whole Dalet section. If you think about it, is he's going to enlarge your heart. How is he going to get you your heart back? Well, he's got to restore it, right? And it starts out with quicken thou me, right? My soul cleaves to the dust. And so as you go back through all these verses of the Dalet section, you can see that this door of humility is going to lead to the place where you can fall more in love with God than you ever have before, where he will enlarge your heart so that you can run, as it were, to do run, 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 like the Shondells are singing about, because their heart, whoever wrote the song, his heart's been enlarged for Bill. There's no doubt about that. So, it's just something that I really pray. I do pray this morning that God would enlarge your heart to just look back through the other seven verses of humility, of, clinging to the dust, of, confession through, telling our ways and clinging to these testimonies, absolutely cleaving like we talked about yesterday or in the previous episode. So the idea, again, is on this eighth verse, here we're going to see the fruit of walking in this door of humility, which, again, is going to get us to the point where God's going to enlarge your heart, and you'll be so smitten for God and for your neighbor that you will literally run, right, to love on them somehow. And what a beautiful thing, as we get so hung up in so many things, that God is going to, through humility, put us in this place that where we really do consider others more than we kid or consider ourselves, consider God first and the others. You know, what an amazing, amazing promise there is in this. Because King David doesn't say, you know, if you enlarge my heart, but he says, when, you know, when you enlarge my heart, I am going to run in the path of your commandments. And if you go back to the first time that somebody runs in the Bible, it gives us another picture of this, right? The first person to run in the Bible was Abraham. And why did he run? He ran because the people had, the angels had come to visit him, and he wanted to show them hospitality. You don't think that his heart was enlarged when all of a sudden God himself showed up, and he ran to go, you know, help get them food and all that kind of thing, which was really, when you read more about Abraham, his heart was about loving his neighbor in so many different ways. And so as God will enlarge our heart, that not only will we fall more in love with God, but when it comes to these mitzvahs, right, the two greatest ones are love God and love your neighbor. So just ponder back with me. You know, when did you feel your heart so enlarged that, oh my goodness, it was so much fun to run in love? To do run, 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 to do run, run.